Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their 36th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 680. The booster which launched this mission, B-1080, then landed successfully for the 17th time and the drone ship just read the instructions. The following day, on Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 37th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of FRAM 2.
One, ignition, and liftoff.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1085, then landed successfully for the sixth time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Legs are deployed. And touchdown after six flights.
A few days later on Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 38th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1113.
One, ignition, and liftoff of the Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
Stage one propulsion is nominal.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1088, then landed successfully for the fifth time on the drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You.
Standing leg deploy.
Then, earlier this morning, SpaceX successfully launched their 39th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 672.
One, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1078, then landed successfully for the 19th time on the drone ship, just read the instructions.
Landing leg deploy.
This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see at least a few Falcon missions launch. The first of these, the Starlink 1111 mission, is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 7th at 11 p.m. UTC or 7 p.m. EDT. Later in the week, we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 127 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 11th at 2:43 a.m. UTC or Thursday 10th at 10:43 p.m. EDT. Then the following day, and we should see a customer mission launch. The NROL 192 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 12th at 1:17 p.m. UTC or 9:17 a.m. EDT. There was an article posted about SpaceX receiving more money for launch contracts for NSSL Phase 3. It says SpaceX has received just shy of $6 billion worth of contracts. Heading to Boca Chica, the flame diverter for the Pad B launch site was seen being installed. Work is continuing with the gantry for the Pad B launch site. Work is also continuing on Orbital Pad B's launch mount. SpaceX are in the process of constructing a new roundabout. The work on scrapping the high bay has been continuing. Work has been seen going on with the structural test stand at Massey's test site. Recently, the Booster 14 vehicle was rolled to the launch site for some testing. It was also lifted and placed on the Pad A launch mount. SpaceX posted some videos and pictures of Booster 14's static fire and confirmed that they will be reflying it on Starship Flight 9. They said static fire of the Super Heavy preparing to launch Starship's 9th flight test. This booster previously launched and returned on Flight 7 and 29 of its 33 Raptor engines are flight proven. In response to that post, they also said the first Super Heavy reuse will be a step towards our goal of zero-touch reflight. Finishing up the video today, we'll take a little look at the Cameron County website. there is currently a temporary closure for Tuesday 8th. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Cesar Garcia for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.